Hi, it's Christina with the Sisyphean Journal, and today we are looking at a very old abortion case, clear back in 1876. And it's not clear who did the abortion. And I'll tell the story, and you tell me below who you think the guilty party was. So 15-year-old Sarah Jane Beaver lived with her mother, Mrs. Sarah Beaver Spencer, and her two brothers, William and Andrew, on a farm owned by a man named Shepherd Cox, in Ursa Township near Quincy, Indiana. Sarah Jane and her brothers were the children of their mother's first marriage prior to the Civil War. Sarah Jane's father was a soldier who had died at Vicksburg. The family went north after the war. They were poor and illiterate. In April of 1876, Mrs. Spencer sent Sarah Jane and one of her brothers to town for some medicine. The two parted ways in town, and the boy was unable to find his sister. He went home to his mother alone. There were sightings of Sarah Jane with Cox in Texas, but she remained at large until late July. About 4 weeks after Sarah Jane returned, Mrs. Spencer, as the news coverage said, discovered that her daughter was in an interesting condition. Sarah Jane named Cox, who was there during the conversation, as the responsible party. Shortly after this conversation, Mrs. Spencer said she discovered a bottle with a few drops of oil of tansy left in it. That was a popular abortifacient. When confronted, Cox reportedly admitted that he had bought the oil of tansy for Sarah Jane. Now, shortly after this confrontation, Cox reportedly came to the house indicating he had two tickets to the Centennialion, which I'm not sure what it is, and he wanted to take Sarah Jane with him so he could take her to a doctor who would make things right. Mrs. Spencer said that she objected to that plan, so Sarah Jane did not go with Cox. About Tuesday, October 17th, Mrs. Spencer said Cox came to the house with something rolled up in a small parcel. She said that she went outside to do chores for about 20 minutes, and when she returned, she found her daughter with a broom in her hands and a flushed face. Sarah Jane denied that Cox had said anything to offend her. She took sick that night, and the following night, she expelled her dead baby. Now, she took ill, and Mrs. Spencer said that she sent for Dr. Duncan. Now, he wasn't able to come to check on Sarah Jane until the following Wednesday, October 25th. Duncan said that Sarah Jane had not miscarried, but had actually undergone an abortion caused by instruments of some sort used with force. Mrs. Spencer was able to show the fetus to Duncan, who said it was about 3.5 months gestation. When Cox came to the house, Mrs. Spencer told him that he had killed her daughter. Cox pointed out that Sarah Jane wasn't dead and that he expected her to survive. Dr. Duncan continued to provide care to Sarah Jane, at first expecting her to recover, but her condition deteriorated. He asked her repeatedly to tell him who had gotten her pregnant and who had injured her. She made a statement to him that was later ruled not admissible in court because at the time she didn't believe that she was dying. Now, on the evening of Friday, October 27th, Sarah Jane called her brothers to her bedside, told them she was dying, and asked them for forgiveness. She then spoke again to Dr. Duncan, telling him that she knew she was dying. He asked again who had injured her. Now, Sarah Jane's mother was there, and she was telling Sarah Jane to tell Dr. Duncan who had done it, but was shaking her head as if to warn Sarah Jane not to speak. Sarah Jane told Dr. Duncan, "I did it." After her mother left the room, Duncan and Sarah Jane had another conversation. Dr. Duncan asked, "Who did it?" "I did." "But who helped you?" "My God, I have done wrong." "Tell me who helped you." "I did." "You could not have done it alone. Who helped you?" "He did it with instruments." Sarah Jane died the following morning. On Sunday, Cox came to the house crying and lamenting Sarah Jane's death. Mrs. Spencer said that Cox told her to keep quiet after the death because if she said anything, she'd get into trouble. He pointed out that she had no money, but he had money and would help the family to pay the doctor bills. Dr. Duncan did corroborate that Cox promised to pay the $56 medical bill, although he did quibble about the price. Andrew and William both corroborated their mother's testimony about Sarah Jane's disappearance, her return, and seeing Cox in the house the night before Sarah Jane took ill, and his visiting her twice during her illness. The boys also testified that they'd heard Cox saying he'd help with the medical bills, and they testified to Sarah Jane's deathbed plea for their forgiveness. Excuse me. Cox was indicted for murder in December of 1876. He fled to avoid prosecution. Eventually, his attorney negotiated a deal for him to return for trial, but to remain free on $3,000 bail, which was a metric butt ton of money in 1876. He was also able to negotiate a change of venue, so the trial took place in neighboring Hancock County. During the trial, several witnesses placed Cox at a distance from the farm on October 17th, the day that the abortion allegedly was performed. Dr. Parks, another area physician, testified that Mrs. Spencer had showed him a catheter and a probe, asking if they could be used to cause an abortion and lamenting that her daughter was pregnant. Parks told Mrs. Spencer the instruments would not cause an abortion. After that, he said he saw the instruments in Dr. Springer's possession, and Springer said that he had bought them from Mrs. Spencer. Another witness, a Mrs. Arnez, stated that when she and Mrs. Spencer were in jail together, Mrs. Spencer told her that Shep Cox had had nothing to do with her daughter's death. It took the jury a full day of sparring to come back with a verdict of not guilty for Mr. Shepherd Cox. So who do you think did the abortion? Do you think it was self-induced by Sarah Jane? Do you think her mother did it? Do you think that Shepherd Cox did it? Or do you think that there was an unknown party, perhaps one of these doctors? Let me know in the comments.